wanted to show you some tips on how to compare things over different time periods in Metabase. There are lots of ways to represent this information. Here are some of them. You can show the latest trend, a table with a percentage change, or a year-over-year bar chart. In this video, I'll show you how to build this year-over-year bar chart, where we have a metric for each month of the current year and compare it to the value a year before. And you can check out the link in the description of the video for a tutorial on those other options. I'm going to use the sample database that comes with every Metabase, so you can follow along. First, I'll create a new question, starting with the orders table, and compute the sum of total column by months. Let me preview. This gives me a table with a row of aggregated data for every month. This is the shape that you need to get your data into before building a year-over-year chart. If I want the data for both the current and previous periods in the same chart, I need to have the columns for both the current and previous periods in the table. And so here's the trick. I go to the summarize block and I add a custom expression. Offset, sum of total, and let me put -1 for now. Call it 1 month ago and preview. We now have a new column that's just the sum of total column, but shifted down. So for every cell, I'm looking up the sum of total value offset by -1, meaning previous months. But of course, I can offset it by any integer. So if -1 looks up a number from 1 month ago, then -12 will give me 12 months ago, or last year. If I preview again, I won't see anything interesting because the preview window is too small, but let me go to visualization and switch to table. There it is. So take a look here at April 2023. It's showing me the actual value for April 2023 and in the next column, the value from April 2022. Okay, we're almost there. There is one piece missing is that I don't actually want the data from the beginning of time. I want to see just the months in the current year and how they compare to months in the previous year. So I'll go back to the editor and I'll add a filter for created at current year. And key point here is that I have to add this filter after the summary. If I add a filter before the summary, I'll just restrict the data selection and I won't be able to offset because there will be no data for the previous year. So at this point, I'll hit visualize and I can change this to a bar chart. A few more things I need to do before this is really ready for prime time. It's very easy to miss, but this chart has a split axis. This can happen when there is a large discrepancy in two series and Metabase tries to help you. But because we want a comparison, we want both series on the same scale. So I'll go to the axis tab and turn off split y-axis. I also want to rename the series for my current year. It's just sum of total right now. I'll rename it current year. And I will reorder the series as well because I want the bars for 1 year ago to come before the bars for the current year. There you go, a year-over-year bar chart in Metabase. We use the offset custom expression to get the data from a year ago, then filtered for current year and did some pretty fine on the chart. Don't forget to check out the link to the expanded tutorial on time series comparison in the description, and I'll see you next time.